radio frequency and microwave laboratory. This is Prashant from RGKT Basar. In this video, we are going to discuss about initial conditions, specifications and operational procedure for Klystron. This is a table setup of microwave components, consists of source, test bench and measuring devices. Before starting any experiment, we have to keep some initial conditions. We start with test bench. Here we have a cooling fan for Klystron tube. This should be on for entire experiment. After the completion of experiment also, we have to keep on for certain period of time, and it is frequency meter. Frequency meter consists of a pair of copper lines. By tuning this frequency meter, these pair of copper lines moves their direction in upwards or downwards. Before starting experiment, we have to keep the pair into down position. Now coming to the Klystron power supply. This is the front panel of Klystron power supply. It consists of two parts. In upper part, which consists of only powers, and down part consists of modulation unit. Here we have beam voltage, reference voltage, variable knobs. We have to keep beam voltage into minimum position, that is pure anti-clock direction, and reference voltage in max position, that is clock direction. And you can observe a push-pull button which indicated with HT. So before starting experiment, it should be in off condition. And now coming to the modulation unit, we have to keep all the variables, variable knobs, we have to keep all the variable knobs in minimum position. It clearly says that, for simply understanding, in this Klystron power supply, except regular voltage, all should be in their minimum position. Regular voltage should be in max position. Now coming to the specifications of Klystron power supply. Here we have a meter selector for beam voltage, beam current and the reference voltage. By keeping this meter selector, we are able to observe reduce or disturb meter. Then we need to know range of beam voltage and reference voltage. Beam voltage consists of 240 to 420 volts DC, and reference voltage consists of minus 80 to minus 270 volts DC. And we have a push-pull button, HT mode. So while pressing this HT mode, we are going to heat up filament, which is consists of 6.3 volts DC. Coming to the modulation unit, we have a modulation selector, AM, FM, external and continuous. For AM, this section is utilized. For FM, this section is utilized. For if you are keeping it to AM mode, these two variables are going to be activated. One is frequency and second one is amplitude. In AM mode, we can generate 500 to 2 kHz of frequency by tuning this variable knob, and up to 110 volts peak to peak. If you are putting into the FM mode, we are going to generate a sort of waveform of 50 to 150 Hz with 60 volts peak to peak. These are the technical specifications. And coming to the frequency meter, which consists of 8 to 12 GHz of range, which lies in X band. And coming to the digital panel meter, it is 0 to 2 milliamps of current and CRO. Now coming to the operational procedure. To perform any experiment, we require source with supply, a test bench and measuring devices. In this lab, we have measuring devices like SWR meter, CRO and ammeter. Who are for beginners, CRO and ammeter are the best option for take readouts. So on power supply. First we are going to on cooling fan, then measuring devices, then Clicked on power supply. By pressing power on button, power will be activated. After pressing HD mode, power goes outside. By using meter select switching, we can observe beam voltage, beam current, and temporary voltages. Now, by selecting beam current mode, by varying beam voltage, we are going to set up to 20 milliamps of current. Then, in modulation, we have to keep AM mode, and at the time, these two probes will be activated. It is frequency and it is amplitude. By varying these two probes into middle portion, we can observe readings on your output end. Now, adjust the regular voltages and amplitude of the AM modulation. We have to maximize the readings. By adjusting these two variables, we have to maximize the readings. So here maximum I am getting around 320. Here I am getting around 350. This is initial current for the experiment. So don't confuse with beam current and Imax current, which I have taken readings from ammeter. Beam current and beam voltage, regular voltages are input to the klystron tube, and after generating a signal, finally at the load end or detector mode, we are going to take readouts as Imax. This is the initial current or maximum current applied by our experiment, and which is utilized for next stage of experiments. That's why it is called initial current or Imaximum current. Note down this reading as well as these three readings. These three readings are, we are going to keep top of the table, and in table we are going to take reading as Imax. This is the difference between beam current and appeared current. Okay, you want to see the values here. If you want to check the wave is, when we connected to CRO, we will get this type of square waves. This is operational procedure. After the completion of experiment, again we have to detach our circuit and by changing regular voltage to the maximum mode, beam current to the minimum mode, and modulation unit to the minimum condition, and after that we have to turn off HD mode first. After turning off your HD mode, it may not directly go to the zero position. And after the of experiment also, we have to keep on your fan for a certain period of time and wait for a few minutes and then power off the klystron power supply. And we are going to perform in this laboratory. For each and every experiment, this is the main procedure we have to follow. Thank you.